Hello friends, you're with the Lonesome Gamer, and I'm playing Level 7 Invasion. So it's turn number 4. Until now we only managed to develop the first two cards, sanctioned by World Conclave and the Recharge, the Fusion Core card. And, well, the Hydra is pushing here in Europe, definitely. So, this is a problem here and down here in South America. I think these are the most critical areas right now. Another problem is the really low military-industrial complex of North America. It's only at 9. So they've lost lots of people there. And that's pretty painful. So they really have to be careful. They really have to take care of every single invader now. Like this guy here, for example, in the Mexican influence zone. Because at the end of the turn, for every area that that contains an invader unit, the MIC goes down one. So that's definitely something we want to avoid. Okay, the first step is again the Gin mercenaries. And now America has the Kronos North America has the Kronos Control token, because Dr. Kronos is here in the eastern US. So they will now be able to buy or to recruit some of these warriors. And well, I think they won't actually recruit any. They don't really need them. South America, well, they might. South America will actually recruit the warrior clones, I guess, for 1 million. Oh, they're already down at 4 million. Holy moly. Anyway, I think they're gonna do that. Okay. And let's draw another one. Oh, that's great. More Gin researchers. This is pretty amazing. The blaster hybrids. Well, interesting. Who might need them? Well, probably nobody. Okay, I think Europe will also not buy any Gin mercenaries, but Africa, they will first buy the Gin researchers for $3, and they will place them, it's hard to say. Is there any area which is safer than the others? No, there isn't. Maybe it's a good idea not exactly place them next to Western Australia. I don't know, maybe in the Nigerian League. Let's place them there. Okay, here we are. And that gives them an extra neutral research lab. And, well, I think this is it then for these guys. And then let's see, finally we get Asia, and they could now, they can buy the Fear Hunter hybrids, also the Gin researchers. Maybe they should do that. They got a lot of money. So I think they will actually hire the Gin researchers and maybe even the Fear Hunter hybrids for $2. Place the Fear Hunter hybrids next to in China. That gives it one higher defense value. And the Gin researchers, well, I don't know if there can, I think there can be also more than one. That's more than one. I don't know if there can be one, more than one laboratory in one area. Well, anyway, let's place these guys here in Siberia. Okay. So here we are. Okay, so that is then the end of the Gin mercenary phase. We have here warrior clones and rogue clones for the next turn. And now we come to the unit deployment phase. Okay, the US or the North American coalition. Well, I think yeah, I think I'm gonna place two here in the Mexican influence zone. I mean, we can still move, so, and maybe one here in Canada and one in the Western US. And that did cost them $4. South America, well, they only have three left. So they can only deploy three troops. And, yeah, they are in trouble. Kind of. So I think they're gonna go here, gonna try to defend the invasion in Peru. What about Europe? Well, they have now the advanced command and control. That means they could now afford two units, two additional units, and they're going to do that. Okay, so let's see. I think I'm going to place one here. And the other one simply here. Africa can afford two units. Or they can control two more units. And well, it doesn't really matter. I mean, they can move everywhere because they are everywhere in this region because they have these. No, actually, they don't. They don't have the anti. Anti-gravity engines, but they can do this. They can develop these in that turn, and that's what they're gonna do. Okay, and well, then it's Asia, and they can recruit two, which costs them $2, and they're simply going to be placed here in China. And this is then the end of the unit deployment. Now we come to the research phase. Okay, so first of all, now North America is pretty behind when it comes to these biological and the social sciences. So they're definitely gonna catch up a little bit here. Overall, they gotta pay, let me see, $3, two food, and their two research centers. Here we are. And that allows them then to develop the hybrid crops and the nutritional advances. So that will lower their, no, let me see, social programs actually. Yeah, the refugee services and the relocation programs. The refugee services, that will be helpful when it comes to the MIC, and that is something they definitely need. Okay, now I'm asking myself if I should actually. I mean, I got enough money to maybe do even more research. All I would need would be another research token. Maybe I should buy a research token. Well, I could buy a research token from South America because they don't have anything at all. They don't have any money. So I guess I'm gonna buy a research token and I'm gonna pay $2 in return for that. Do I want to trade more with these guys? Let me see what they might need. No, I think not. They might do the communications. Okay. Yeah, I think that's fine. And then I could actually upgrade my communications. You can only upgrade a single category once per turn. So I'm gonna pay now $2, one oil, one fuel, and this research center, and that then brings me to tier 3 of the communications. So this is then information control. Whenever a viral video event requires you to make a roll, can avoid rolling any number of dice by spending 1 million for each die. The propaganda, which we already had, and now the mesh networks. You gain +2 to your command and control. So that is definitely amazing because they have then 8. That's very strong. And actually, I forgot something. I made a mistake here. But I did that earlier on. Or two, when you buy these GIN researchers, you will have to place a committed neutral research token on it. So you cannot use these guys in that same turn. I made a mistake earlier on concerning that, but now I will remember that. So, okay, here we are. Oops. Okay. South America, they will develop the advanced command and control, which gives them +1 for command and control. And that costs them, ah, damn it. 2 million and a research center. this one here, and they have exactly 2 million. Europe, what are they gonna do? Let me see. Well, I think they want to give one of their research centers to Africa, because they really need to upgrade their military equipment. Interesting question. Well, they could do the... Well, they have food. They don't have much fuel. So maybe it's a good idea to say, okay, I need fuel. And in return, I'll give you that research center. Yeah, I think that makes sense. So here we are, one research center for Africa and one fuel for me. Okay. Yeah, that's fine. Okay, I'm gonna develop here. I'm gonna develop the education campaigns. Roll a die at the end of the maintenance phase. If you roll a minus, lower your terror by one level. And the mandatory counseling. Roll a die when affected by a paranoia event. If you roll an equal, you do not suffer the effects of the event. Okay, that costs me... Okay, it costs me 1 million, one food, one oil, and a research center. Okay, and finally, I'm gonna develop my communications to number 3, 2 million, one oil, one research center. And that gives me then also the mesh networks with an additional command and control. Okay, Africa has traded this research center, so they have now 2 available. So they're gonna pay $4. And 3 oil, 3 minerals, and yeah, the 2 research centers. And now they have also the powered exoskeletons and the anti-grav engines. So that goes down to 4, and that goes down to 9. And that's it then. Okay, and finally it's Asia. Okay, Asia developed the education campaigns, the mandatory counseling, and the mesh networks. And that's then the end of the research phase. We come to the Kronos project. And this time we want to upgrade that. So we got to pay 4 food and 4 million. And that is not a problem at all. Actually, I think Asia is going to pay all the money. They have a lot of money. And let me see. I mean, Europe has a lot of food. They might pay maybe 3 food, and Asia can pay 1 food. And that means now that the military escort was developed. Increase the size of the Gin market by 1. Kronos can move through territories that contain dropships. Okay, so this is now, he cannot end his move, by the way, in these territories, but we can move through these. That was then the second card, or the third card, and now we got to draw our last Gin Mercenary card, and these are Rogue Clones again. Let's see what the next one would be. So that would be the Psychotronic Amplifier Trials. Okay, well, first of all, if we upgrade this, then it says here the devastation stage is triggered at the end of the current round. So that is a tough, then they really start rocking. It's also going to be pretty expensive, lots of food, fuel, some minerals, and here it costs also 5 MIC, so that is pretty painful. But it says, each coalition can immediately upgrade one technology without paying the upgrade costs. So that is definitely cool too. And the guy has to be in Europe. But that should not be a big deal. We can simply move here to the Western Europe Defense Pact, and this is it then. Okay, it's now the income phase, and this is something I will do off camera. Okay, then we can do the movement, and well, okay, North America starts. And first of all, that's important. I want to throw the guys out of the Mexican influence zone. And I think about helping South America out in Venezuela, but I need to do that. I think I can do that. I need two. So I could help them in Venezuela. And then I will actually move to Greenland with these three and try to secure these resources there. I mean, North America is not exactly threatened right now, so I think this is a good time to do that. As long as I have the troops available, I will try to attack that dead zone. Then I have to move Dr. Kronos, and I'm gonna simply move him here. Maybe actually here. I mean, why not? And this is it then, the movement for North America. We come to South America and they're not going to move at all. That's all they do here. Try to defend Peru from being overrun. Europe. Well, that's more interesting. It should be good enough to be here with one person, because there are these blaster hybrids in the Western European Defense Pact zone. So they already have one additional power there. Yes, and then, well, I guess they simply move with two here to the Nordic Confederacy, and with two here into the Russian influence zone. Africa. Well, they're going to help out the Europeans, or at least they're going to try to do so. They're going to move with all four here. It's not going to be easy there, but they're probably going to lose again. But we can try it anyway. And Asia? What are they gonna do? It's an interesting question. Well, I'm thinking about attacking Western Australia, but I would need about three troops to do that. So, and I could go with these three troops here over India to Western Australia and attack them. But then I only have these three from Siberia left to protect China. And I think that's not good enough. So what I'm going to do instead is I'm going to move with one here to China. And not even sure that is good enough, honestly. But the good thing is we can actually move there with two and with one to the Uzbekistan alliance, because in the Uzbekistan alliance we also have here the blaster hybrids. So they give me an additional power. So we can defend this guy. Okay, that's the end of the movement, and then we come to the events phase, and we're going to start that off camera. Okay, let's go through the alpha events first. A viral video. Each coalition rolls once for the following. So let's see. The first one would be North America again. Do they have something against that? Yeah, there is this information control. Well, they could simply spend 1 million. Ah, damn. Okay, I think they're gonna do that. So they simply pay 1 million. And then they don't have to roll. Whenever a viral video event requires you to make a roll, you can avoid rolling any number of dice by spending 1 million for each die. Okay, and basically I think the same would be possible for South America. So they're also gonna do that. I think we all gonna do this, and I think we all can. Yeah, we all have this information control ability. So we all pay $1 instead. And we don't want to lose, we don't want to raise the terror level or reduce our food, fuel and minerals or destroy one of our coalition units. And then we have to place invader units on dropship number one, dropship number two, and one in Western Australia. Okay. So this is now a defense value of 2. That means the unit will move somewhere else. So we have contains the fewest invader units, contains the fewest coalition units. So actually we can choose between the Kenyan Federation, India, and the Indonesian refugee zone. Well, I think I'm going to go for the refugee zone. I think that that Africa is already pretty busy. They're not that strong. In India, we have a research center. So we don't want India overrun, because that would mean we could not ready the research center at the end of the turn. So I guess it's okay to place it here. Of course, there is a little bit of a risk. I mean, if we draw a stupid dropship card, then this zone is overrun very fast. So maybe I think I'm going to place it here, the Kenyan Federation. I think that is an advantage here. Okay, next one, again an alpha event. This is a crop decimation. Each coalition reduces its food 1 point. If your dial is already at 0, return 1 million to the bank. Okay, I think we have some technology against that. And that would be the hybrid crops. So if we roll an equal, we do not suffer the effect. Let's start with North America here. Okay, that's good. Yeah, we all have them. South America? Nope. So food goes down. Europe, okay. Africa, damn it. Okay, so they all lose 1 foot. Foot. Here we have a paranoia. Each coalition returns 1 million to the bank. And again, I think we got something against that. Don't we? Not sure, actually. I thought we had. Yeah, there is this mandatory counseling here. Royal Diamond affected by a paranoia event. If you're all unequal, you do not suffer the effects. Okay. So that means only a few have this mandatory counseling. So if we start with the North America, and they have to pay anyway. They don't have that. South America too. They have to pay too. And now Europe, they might be lucky. They do have this mandatory counseling. And no, doesn't help here. Africa also has to pay. But Asia also has mandatory counseling. So, damn it. Very unlucky here. Okay, but it could have been worse until now. So, but I forgot to place... I forgot to place aliens. 1 and 2. So one goes here. The other one goes here. And here we got 1 and 3. So here we are. Wait a second. That's not possible, actually. Ah, damn it. I made a mistake here. The North African Concord. Okay, so that means now these guys, this is... actually a 2 here, so they cannot be more than 2 units be spawned here, so they move somewhere else. And well, I wonder where that might be. Oh no, it's not. It's actually pretty clear. It has to be where Dr. Kronos is. Contains Kronos. So they will both move here, which sucks, because it is now possible that this region might become overrun in the next turn. Oh, damn. Okay. That's really bad. And this is my capital, so that is a problem. Okay, we got 2 left. Let's hope we don't have to place another one at dropship number 1. These are first the Bravo. Yeah, here we go. Dropship number 1. The Bravo event. So we got here a viral video. The coalition with the Kronos standee rolls twice for the following. So let's see. Do we have the information control? Yeah, we do. So we can pay $2 to avoid that. But we have to place a, we have to spawn another unit here, which is really bad, and another one in Greenland. And this guy also moves away and moves to Canada then, because this is then the one which contains the fewest invader units. Okay, and the final card is now... oh boy. Well, damn, I was damn lucky actually here. I see now in Europe, I have these Fear Hunter hybrids, which give me an additional defense value. So that means this is not overrun yet. And... it won't be, I hope. So the coalition with the most Gin mercenary cards rolls twice for the following. So we have now, Europe has 3, Asia has also 3. So I guess I can choose here. I'm going to choose Asia. And they also have the information control. So they're gonna pay $2 to avoid this role, and then this viral video has absolutely no effect. But we got to place one here at 2 and another one here at 3. So there was only one at 3. This is really ridiculous. Let me see. No, there was one before. Okay, so there got to be 2 at number 3. Anyway. Okay. So now it comes to the battle, and we start with North America. So they have a power of 2. So do the aliens. Well, they outnumber these guys in Greenland. So let's start with the battle in Greenland here. Okay. And they both lose one. But that means now that Greenland is now under control of North America. As long as there is at least one unit, they will gain 2 minerals in the income phase. So that is definitely pretty good and useful. Then we see here the Mexican influence zone. Same thing, the Americans outnumber the aliens. They have the same power, so the Americans are the attackers and no casualties here. And I forgot to adjust the adaption dial, so it goes up to 8. And then in Venezuela, again, the Americans are the attackers, and that was already also a good roll. So overall, I think we had a pretty successful battle phase here. And this time, because now North America developed the refugee services, they won't suffer a damage from this single guy in Canada. They can reduce the damage by 1, which would be exactly this. So that's cool. So then it's South America, and this is not looking that great. They only have this big battle here, and well, they might actually lose, but they can try to improve their odds a little. Usually they would be the defenders here, because they have a strength of 2, so does the Hydra. They have 4 units, the Hydra, the Americans only have 3, means they would be clearly the defenders. But they have purchased the warrior clones, so they're going to play this card now. And this allows them, this gives them an additional power. So they have now a power of 3, while the Hydra has only a power of 2, so that makes them the attackers. And with a little bit of luck, they might even be able to push back this invasion. Yeah, not like that, I'm afraid. So that was a loss for the attacker. That's a good one, fine. And actually this goes up now a little bit. Okay, 1 from each. It's not looking that great, actually. There's only 1 left here, so they gotta be lucky now. Ah, damn it, they didn't make it. It sucks. Okay, anyway, it's not overrun, it's not that bad, but was a little bit unlucky. The first one would not have been that minus, but okay, wasn't a good fight here. And yeah, this goes up again, so now the Hydra will actually adapt. Let's see what we got here. A ground push. Spawn one invader unit at the lowest numbered dropship. If there's no dropship in play, move two invader units one territory closer to Dr. Kronos. Okay, so that would be one here. And that sucks completely. That sucks completely. Now, this was really a terrible card because that means we got to spawn that thing. So we got to place it here, and this will move then here. So that means now, because there is Dr. Kronos, and that means now that this area is overrun, and that is my capital. So this is definitely not good. Oh, man. Okay, and then it's Europe. And they have a lot of battles. Well, not too many, actually. Three battles to fight. We start here in the West European Defense Pact. And because there are these blaster hybrids over here, they have an additional strength there. And so that gives them a power of 3, while the others only have a power of 2. So Europe is the attacker here. And if we don't roll a minus now, yeah, okay, that was good. So the invader was defeated here. Now the Nordic Confederacy, also Europe is the attacker because they outnumber the other guys. That is very good. Another success here. And finally, the Russian influence zone also, yeah, that is good. At least something here. Still, they have a big problem because of that. So Europe is still in trouble. Now we're going to see Africa, and there is this big fight here in the North Africa Concord. And, well, actually, we outnumber these guys, so maybe we're lucky. We should be able to kill them. It would be important also for Europe, because in general, this is a European zone. Okay, that's a good start. Fabulous. Second one. And now there is only the dropship remaining. So attack this now. Very good. That was cool. So no losses here. The dropship goes down. And that means we can now choose. I wonder what we want. Maybe some food. Food is always pretty useful for Africa. The other hand, well, they do have enough. Not sure. What do we need next here? Well, food, yeah, we need a lot of food for the next upgrade. So I guess I'm gonna go for food here. Okay. Then we're gonna see the battles here in Asia. And here we also have the blaster hybrids. So Asia has here a power of 3, while the Hydra only has a power of 2. That means they attack and both lose 1. But that's okay. And now finally here, the bigger battle in China. And there, the Asians outnumber the invaders, so they also are the attackers. Okay. One each. again, one from both sides. Well, it's an expensive battle, but in the end, I guess we will win that. Only the dropship is left now. Yeah, okay. And it is shot down. So this thing, the adaptation dial is now at 10, so we'll see an adaptation pretty soon in the next turn. Okay, let me see what we're gonna do here. Seems to me like we might need a lot of fuel, so I think I'm gonna go for fuel. Okay. Well, we were a little unlucky here in Peru, and also, especially here, that was very, very unlucky that this is now overrun. So that is now checked in the next phase, and this is now it. This Union of Central European States is overrun. What does that mean? Well, it means that the Fear Hunter hybrids are killed. If the territory is overrun, discard this card. So that goes away. And then we got to find that card here. Let me see. Here we got the European cards. Yeah. Okay. And that sucks because there's also a... Oh boy, that's expensive. We really lose a lot of money here. We lose 2 food. And we cannot ready our research center. So that was really something that should not have happened. Okay. Then we're gonna see invader movement, and because now this has only a defensive level of 3 and there are 3 there are 4 invaders there, we're probably gonna move out there, although I'm not absolutely sure what happens if Kronos is there. I'm gonna check that. Okay, so they won't move because there is this Kronos standee here, so they stay there. That's an exception. It was actually a pretty stupid idea to move this guy here into my capital, because now I will also gain a capital damage marker for Europe, for this Union of Central European States. And if there are ever 3 markers here, and I will gain another one at the end of next turn if this thing is not liberated until then. And if there should be ever 3 markers there, the capital is destroyed and Europe is out of the game, which should not happen. Okay. Then we come to the Kronos control step, so that means now that the Kronos marker goes to Europe. The terror level. Okay, let's see. Well, the only coalition that is completely free of any terror is the Asian coalition. There is no invader unit in there. All the others have at least one, so that means that the terror level will go up in all other coalitions. But we can actually do something against that. No, not here. Okay. We have the relocation programs. You can lower your terror by 1 level during each maintenance phase by spending 1 million. Okay, so the Americans will do that. In addition, they're going to spend 2 million for propaganda, and that allows them to spend to lower this thing one more level. So this is now at zero. Okay, and they will also use the relocation programs, pay $1 to bring this down. So will Africa and also Europe. Okay, I did the MIC damage phase. This is the phase where the population gets killed by the aliens. And because everyone had refugee services, we could reduce the MIC damage done by units by one. Of course, we have the MIC damage because of the toxic of the poison the aliens spread over the world, which kills also thousands and millions and whatever people. So what happened in the end was that Brazil lost, apart from this toxic loss, one more, and so did Africa, because there are two areas that contained these units, but all the others only have one or no area containing invader units. Fine, so then we're gonna see the research readiness. Okay, so that means basically we can flip all our research tokens, but, and this is now something new, we can't flip that one because it's overrun. So that sucks. Okay, here we are. Okay, and the last step would be then the dropship step. So that means we will remove this dropship here, replace it with an invader unit, and then draw a dropship card. And we're gonna see a dropship in Argentina. It's really weird. I mean, these guys are so heavily attacked by the Hydra. It is unbelievable, really. South America is really in trouble, especially Argentina. And it's going to be very hard to defend this. Probably it will be overrun in the next turn. The South African influence zone, this is also not good. There's already one in there. And then the North Africa Concord again. So, yeah. Well, that sucked now quite a bit. The problem is, we cannot move from here, from the North Africa Concord, down there to the South African influence zone in one move. So that means this thing is overrun and there is nothing we can do against it. It's a problem. What we could do, though, is we could at least place them here in the Central African Accord and the Kenyan Federation. So if they land here and then spread out, we can at least defend these two territories, and I guess I'm gonna do that. Question is what to do with this North Africa Concord. And I don't know, maybe. I mean, I gotta get rid of these guys here. Honestly, I really don't know what to do here. This is going to be a tough decision. This is not good. We'll have a lot of problems with these guys. Argentina will be overrun. That's nearly for sure. We could think about helping them with these guys here from Venezuela. Maybe we can go here and try it, but I don't know. We'll see about that later. Okay, yeah, it's going to be an interesting next turn, I guess. So, hope to see you then, or on lonesomegamer.com. Until then, bye.